The dengue virus is transmitted to humans by the mosquito Aedes aegypti and is a major cause of disease in tropical and subtropical regions. The virus belongs to the family Flaviviridae, which includes viruses such as yellow fever virus, West Nile virus, and Zika virus. The journey of the dengue virus begins when an infected mosquito bites a human. As it feeds, the mosquito's saliva, which contains the virus, is injected. Some of the virus is injected into the bloodstream, and some enters the epidermis and dermis. Viral replication begins in the skin. When the virus attaches to a skin cell, it is taken inside via an endosome and brought deep into the cell. As the endosome gets deeper into the cell, the environment becomes more acidic and the endosome's membrane gains a negative charge. The virus detects these changes and exits the endosome once it is deep in the cell by fusing its viral membrane with the endosomal membrane. This fusion releases the dengue nucleocapsid into the cell's cytoplasm. The nucleocapsid then releases the virus's RNA genome. The virus hijacks the host's replication machinery to make copies of itself and uses the ribosomes on the rough endoplasmic reticulum to translate the RNA. The resulting polypeptide is cut to form the 10 dengue proteins. The membrane of the rough endoplasmic reticulum is used to surround the virus's nucleocapsid. Immature viruses go through the Golgi and are released from the cell when they are mature. This is how dendritic cells of the skin called Langerhans cells, which are present in the epidermis and act as antigen-presenting cells, get infected. The infected cells migrate to the lymph nodes, recruiting monocytes and macrophages, which in turn also become infected. The presence of the virus triggers a strong inflammatory reaction. During the incubation period, the virus first replicates locally, then it spreads to the bloodstream. During this viremia, in other words, presence of viruses in the bloodstream, blood-derived monocytes become infected. Sometimes, a severe form of the disease occurs, such as dengue hemorrhagic fever, in which the blood vessels become permeable, leaking plasma and resulting in symptoms such as bleeding under the skin, frequent vomiting, and abdominal pain. When a mosquito bites someone infected with dengue, it draws in the blood containing the virus and can then spread it to someone else. One characteristic of dengue that makes it difficult to treat is the fact that it has four serotypes. The serotypes are closely related, but interact differently with antibodies in human blood serum. Although someone infected with one serotype will develop lifelong immunity to that serotype, they will not be protected against the others. Because there is homotypic immunity, the body recognizes the other serotypes as being similar to the original dengue infection. However, repeated exposure to the dengue virus actually makes it more likely that the person will develop the severe form of the disease, and it is possible to be infected by all four serotypes in one lifetime. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. It would help me make more videos. And make sure to comment with any topics you'd like me to cover in future videos. Also, it would be really nice if you could support me on Patreon. Thank you!